हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन। दिस सेशन इज़ ऑन इनोवेशंस इन टीचिंग लर्निंग इन वोकेशनल एजुकेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज़ द पेडागॉजी ऑफ टीचिंग एंड आल्सो वी विल गो फॉर द डिस्कशन ऑफ ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्रोसेस। सो दिस इज़ अ सेशन विच इज़ डिवोटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वी मीन बाय एजुकेशन, व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द लर्नर्स। ऑल्सो we will discuss the existing scenario of vocational education in India, and then we will go for how technology can be used in improving this scenario. That is, in this session we will understand what are the characteristics of the online learning or what is the process involved in the online learning. So friends, before we start, we go for the famous quote of Yeats, in which he has said that education is not just filling of a bell but lighting of a fire. That is, while designing the curriculum, one should not incorporate many more subjects into the curriculum, but at the same time the teacher has to see that he can set on fire the minds of the students. If the teacher is able to do this, then probably he is giving the best possible education. So this is a famous quote by the William Butler Yeats, and the teacher has always to remember this quote before he go for the teaching profession. In India, we are familiar with Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore has told us that a children has to gather the knowledge through their life, because children are always in love with their life, and it is their first love. The life is full of color and movement. So this color and movement will attract their eager attention, and then they becomes ready to gather the knowledge from other resources. So this quote of Rabindranath Tagore has to be remembered by us, and we should encourage our students to get the knowledge not only from the course curriculums but through the life experiences. Before we start, let us understand about learners. Learners will do the best when they feel a need to know. Learning is best in the non-threatening and the flexible learning environment. So the environment that we offer should be non-threatening. The environment that we offer should be flexible enough. Also, we should encourage our students to learn through life experiences, because through life experiences they can draw the skills, and these skills will help them to achieve their life goals. Also, the learners will respond when they feel acknowledged and respected. So not only students give respect to the teachers, but teacher also should give respect to the student, and the teacher also should acknowledge their students for their good work. It's possible that the learner can gain the knowledge through the senses. So there are different senses, and these senses can be used in order to gain the knowledge. For example, we can smell, we can see, we can hear. So about 80% of the knowledge we can gain through our eyes only. There are certain characteristics about the learners. So whenever a learner is asked to read, then about 10% of what he read can be retained. When a learner hear, then about 20% of what they hear can be retained. But when they see anything, then about 30% of it they can retain. But if they see and they hear simultaneously, then about 50% of the knowledge can be retained by a student. And when whatever they have seen and whatever they have heard, if they talk among each other, then the 70% of the knowledge can be retained by a student. And if they start doing it, then about 90% of the knowledge can be retained by a student. So a teacher has always to remember that whenever he is offering any education to the student, then he has to see that they should do the experiment based on the knowledge on their own. There is a famous quote by the mathematician Confucius, and he has said that I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. I do and I understand. So it is possible that by doing the things, one can easily understand the things. So whenever you want to gain anything, then the best way of gaining the thing is to do it. So there are four P's of the teaching. The first P, that will stand for to prepare. So before any teacher goes for teaching, a teacher must prepare himself. Then he should present. The second P is for the present. So he should present the preparation to the students. Also, whatever is being gained by the teacher should be practiced by the teacher and students both. And then they can make the use of it. That is, they can perform. The last P is for the perform. That is, they should use of the knowledge in the real life examples. Now we will go for understanding existing scenario of vocational education in India. If we refer to the National Education Policy Document 2020, then one can easily find that in India, less than 5% of the formal education is offered for the vocational education stream. While in case of developed countries such as USA, Germany and South Korea, the percentage is much higher. In USA, it is about 52%. In Germany, it is about 75%. And in South Korea, it is about 96%. So these are the developed countries. And in those developed countries, the percentage of formal education is much higher. So ultimately, it is a need of our country that we should spread this vocational education at a rapid rate. So vocational education should be offered at all levels. So whenever we think of vocational education, you can say, is a skill-based education. That is any education which will offer you to gain some skill which is required for living a life can be called as a vocational education. So vocational education in India is being targeting to a percentage of 50% of formal education in schools and higher education by the year 2025. So vocational education is being offered at different levels. In schools from class 9, it is being offered in the form of the levels 1, 2, 3 and 4. So class 9, 10, 11 and 12. So that will cover the vocational education up to level 4. In colleges, the vocational education is being offered at the level 5, 6 and 7. In colleges, you will find that nowadays, the vocational degree such as a BHOK degree is being introduced. And this degree will cover the level of 5, 6 and 7. So this degree is quite flexible. That is, even if a student is able to complete one semester course, then he will be offered a certificate. If the student is able to complete 1 year course, then he will be offered a diploma certificate. So this is a course in which the entry can be taken at any point and also the exit can be made at any point. Also in university, there are different degree courses or postgraduate degree courses. In all such degree programs, the skill-based papers are added to the existing curriculums. So this is enriching the level of vocational training in the formal education also. So ultimately, every efforts are being taken by us so that we can reach to the target of 50% formal education by the year 2025. Level 8 and 9, these are the levels which refers to the postgraduate degree in the vocational education. So nowadays, there is no vertical limit for the vocational education. In early days of vocational education, we used to have some restrictions on the vertical limit. But nowadays, it is possible that a student can enter into the vocational education stream in the class 9 and he can go even up to PhD level by doing this vocational education. So practically, there is no limit on achieving any degree in the vocational education. We can go for the vocational education, and vocational education can be enhanced by making the use of technology. So nowadays, we have a lot many technological tools with us, And by using these technological tools, we can achieve our vocational education. There are certain components which can be used in order to achieve the education through technology. There are three components. The first component is the equipment. So whenever you want to achieve the education through technology, then it is necessary that you can make the use of equipment such as computers and the equipments of networking. Another resource is the digital resource. There are several online services available. There are softwares available. There are application packages available. There is a lot of computing content. There are certain authors program. There are certain platforms. There are certain websites and electronic libraries. All these resources can be used in the education. Also, the third component that we need is the network. So whenever we want to go for any education, online education, then there is a need of network. The network can be either an intranet or it can be an internet. So we can make the use of communication technologies. So communication technologies are used in order to transfer the message from one source to another source. And these technologies can be used in education. So when I'm delivering this session to you, then I'm also actually making the use of technology in order to deliver this session to you. I'm recording this session in PSSCIVE NCERT studio at Bhopal, and this video is being made available to you online, and you anywhere by sitting at home can watch this video. So ultimately what we are doing is that we are making the use of technology in order to deliver this session. Now we will go for what kind of categories are available as far as the digital resources are concerned. So there are six different categories available. The first one is the portal, or sometimes we call it as a gates. There are different search engines such as Google search engine. There are certain directories available, and there are certain software tools available which can be used in delivering the technology-based education. There are lot many software packages available. Also, there are communication protocols or communication services, and by making the use of these software packages and communication services, we can deliver the education. There is a lot of general reference documents data available, and this data can be used in order to deliver the education. So all these are the resources that can be used whenever you want to teach your students online. So it is possible that in schools and colleges, we can make the use of training applications. We can make the use of several softwares. We can make the use of the different communication technologies in order to deliver the education. And whenever we offer any online education, then that will help us to improve the quality of education. There are four qualities of technology-based education. So let us understand what these four qualities are and what we can earn by using the online education. The first quality is the multimedia quality, that whenever we make an online education, then it will consist of many medias. Say for example, it will consist of audio, it will consist of video, also it will consist of some graphics. So the corporation of so many medias together is possible only through online education. Otherwise, in classroom teaching, you will find that for a teacher, it becomes difficult to incorporate many medias together. The online education can be interactive. So whenever I offer any web-based form or any Google form, then it is possible that through that form, a student can interact. Also, it is possible that we can conduct the live online sessions, and through live online sessions, a student can ask questions to the teacher, or the interactivity is possible. The third characteristics of the online education is that we can make the use of the hypermedia, and this education, you can say, is the ubiquity. That is, the same education will be offered at par with all students. So this is what we refer as the ubiquity. There are 7 categories of education. So the first category of the education is the television. So through television, you can offer education. So schools and colleges can have correspondence course, or they can conduct the virtual class, and all such virtual class or correspondence course can be offered through the television. So teleconference is also possible. The another characteristics is that we can make the use of edition. That is, we can publish a paper or we can publish a book. This publication can be achieved in the form of hardcore publishing, or the publishing can be made on the website as well. So we can publish a website, and on the website, the notes or books can be made available to the students in the PDF formats. So they can easily download these books on their computer systems or on their mobile phones. We can make the use of search engines. We can search and we can make the use of documentary management. That is, there are several retrieval systems, and it is possible that we can orient the student to the choice of the career. So choice of the career can be made through online education. We can make the use of collection of information, and whatever the information that is being gathered, this information can be shared with many other students irrespective of where they are. So this flow of information or the virtual collaboration is possible only when we go for the online learning programs. We can achieve problem solving. We can prepare the groups of the students, and through the interactions, we can solve the individual problems of the students. We can create the virtual laboratory. So even if the student is not able to make an access to the actual laboratory, virtually we can create a laboratory. Every student who is sitting at very corner of India is making an access to the virtual laboratory. So he can perform the experiments, he can start coding, he can write algorithms, and he can perform any kind of experiment by sitting at home only, and this is possible only through the virtual laboratory. Learning and distance learning is possible through the online education. So this distance learning will support the presentations of the lessons. So as I am sharing my presentation with all of you, so you can watch this presentation by sitting at home. So there are different objects of learning, and all these objects of learning can be achieved through online education. That we can do the projects, we can achieve the learning which is interdisciplinary or transdisciplinary. There are a lot of new technologies available nowadays, and all these technologies can be used in educational process. The first technology which is being available is the artificial intelligence. The human intelligence is a natural intelligence, and the machine intelligence, you can say, is a artificial intelligence. So when the machine works like that of human beings, when the machine thinks like that of human beings, then it can be called as an artificial intelligence. So we can write algorithms, we can write programs, or we can prepare some special hardware through which the artificial intelligence can be achieved. That machine also can learn. And when machine start learning on their own, then that can be called as a machine learning. We human beings can learn on our own. We learn through experiences. That machine also can learn through experiences. There are other technologies such as blockchain technology, smart boards, or many handheld devices. Smart boards, you can say, are just like the smartphones. Our phones are nowadays quite smart. That is, they can do many things on their own. That we can make the use of adaptive computer testing for testing of the performance of the student. Some special hardware and software that is being devoted for the purpose of education. So educational hardware, educational software can be used whenever we want to deliver online sessions. So whenever we go for the use of technology in delivering the sessions, then that will definitely give us certain advantages. So technology will allow us to teach the same topic in a very different way or in a very new way. It is possible that we can explain, we can show, we can demonstrate, we can monitor, and we can supervise our learners, that is our students. And this can be achieved in a very different manner. That is, the way we pace the content to one student can be different from that of other student. The way we can judge our one student can be different from the other student. And this is possible only through online learning or online teaching. We can prepare the content or the knowledge in a very individual way. We can offer this content so that they can be interactive. The interactive in a sense that the learning will not be only one way, that it will become a two way. That is, the student will do the something, the teacher will also participate in doing the things, and this way we can explore the education. So we can question both the concepts of time and space by reducing the distance and by changing the presence according to the new interesting modalities for the education. So this is possible only through online education. Online education in India is being offered by the different sources. Say, for example, we have National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning, or we have a program called as a SWAM. So you can have the online learning platform, YouTube, on which there are different resources are available. Many of these resources have been prepared by the government of India, and these resources are being made available to the students free of cost. That is, you can enroll to the any particular course, NPTEL course or SWAM course of your interest without paying any fees. You can complete this course without paying any fees. Only when you want to appear for examination or whenever you want to obtain any certificate, only at that time you have to pay some minimum amount of fees for the examination purpose. Otherwise, there is no fees for education for these online platforms. So a large number of courses are available on the SWAM platform, or large number of courses are available on the YouTube. A teacher and a student must learn how to make the use of these platforms in order to gain the knowledge. So whenever a teacher goes for using technology, then he can achieve many things by using the technology. Say, for example, if a teacher has to prepare his timetable, then he can do it by making the use of technology. If the teacher wants to present some knowledge or some facts, then he can make the use of presentation for the purpose of teaching. It is possible that a teacher can deliver assignments, and these assignments can be delivered through the web or through the mail, or by making the use of online platforms. Online teaching, class conduction, and examination can also be prepared by making the use of the technology. A teacher can publish notes. A teacher can publish book online. The student and teacher, both of them can update themselves with the recent technologies or with the recent development by making the use of these online resources. So online resources, whenever are used by the teacher, then that will bring you the interactivity in the teaching learning process. And whenever the interactivity is brought in the teaching learning process, then that will not remain a one way, but it will become a two way process. And the two way process is always useful for the learning. Every student will have certain needs, and he will require certain help. So the help to the students can be provided by creating the groups of the students. So online, even though physically we are separated, it is possible that online we can get connected together through a group. And whenever we are get connected through the group, then we can share the experiences or we can share the knowledge with each other. And also we can share the difficulties so that the solutions for these difficulties can be achieved through the online learning help. E-learning websites are available in India. The first one is the Diksha, which will stand for the Digital Infrastructure for Knowledge Sharing platform. So this is a platform which will offer the learners with lot of learning material. It will also offer the prescribed school curriculums, and it will be helpful not only to the students, but it will be helpful to the teachers and parents also. There is another website, NROER, which will stand for the National Repository of Open Educational Resource. So this is a website, and this is a website which will bring together everyone who is interested in school and teacher education. So both student education and teacher education can be achieved by this website, and this website is being managed by CIET, NCERT. So NCERT is playing a large role in doing the things online. NCERT at Delhi and NCERT at Bhopal has prepared this platform, and this platform is being prepared along with the Homi Bhabha Center for Science and Education. There is another website, and this website is called as the NISTA, which is National Initiative for School Heads and Teacher and for School Principals. NISTA is a capacity building program for improving quality of school education through integrated teacher training. It aims to build the competences among the all teachers and school principals at the elementary stage. Another resource that is being available online is ePathshala. This is a Digital India campaign which has promoted the extensive use of ICT in the teaching learning process. ePathshala is a joint initiative of Ministry of Education, Government of India, and NCERT has developed a showcasing and the other resources such as e-resources for the purpose of education. The resources such as textbooks, audio, video, periodicals, and variety of digital resources are being made available to the students for online learning. Another platform that is being available in India is the Swayamprabha, which is the group of 34 DTH channels that are being devoted to the telecasting of high quality educational programs. And these programs are available 24/7 through the GSAT satellite. So every day, certain amount of new content are offered on these channels. So it is possible that a student, by sitting at home and by watching these channels, can learn on their own. Friends, finally, a teacher has said, the day teachers at last will stop teaching, then the students really will start learning. Students need to understand that it is not only a teacher who will deliver them the knowledge, but there are so many other resources are available, and these resources they need to understand. And once they understand that these are the resources, then through these resources they can start learning on their own. So what the teacher has to do is that the teacher has to prepare a student for learning so that he can learn, and this learning process will go on throughout his life. So learning will never stop by doing a course. So learning goes on continuously as long as the human beings are there on this earth. So always we can go for the technology-based learning. So if somebody asks that my mobile phone knows everything, then why should I go to the college or school? Then a teacher can answer to this query, because mobile phone content everything, your computer content everything, website content a lot of data and information. But understanding of this data is not possible to a machine. The understanding will come to only human beings. And by understanding this information, only human beings are going to solve the problem, or only human beings are going to create the new knowledge. So even if your mobile phone knows everything, even if your computer knows everything, one has to go to the college, one has to go to the school for the purpose of learning. And this learning should be the technology-based learning. Thank you all.